You awake in the frozen wastes. The barren land is cold and familiar. This isn't what was promised by your ancestors, but there is still hope. If you can reprogram the dormant machines, you can create utopia. But you are not alone. There is another who seeks the same, and another who seeks to claim the North. The North is a head-to-head card game that combines elements of deck building and competitive dueling. You will compete against an opponent to try and revitalize the frozen wastes by reprogramming ancient machines that will grant victory points and abilities, while also bleeding your opponent of victory points in the process. Players begin with a deck of four cards placed in their zone. The remaining cards form a waste deck and are placed in the center of the play area. Four cards are revealed to form the wastes. Each card represents an ancient with the value depicted by the hash marks in the upper left next to the name, and its abilities on the bottom. On the reverse is a facility with its own ability. Each player will have a node and a point tracker with a reference card. To start your turn, shuffle your hand, discard, and deck together to form a new draw deck and draw three cards to make up your hand. Your turn now begins. You must take three total actions from a menu of four, never repeating a single action more than twice. The first action is to discard an ancient from your hand and take an ancient from the waste row of a different value. Add the new ancient to your discard pile and activate the spark ability written on the card. The next action is to discard an ancient from your hand and take the top card of the waste deck and add it to your zone as a facility. Doing this will activate the protocol ability of that card. You can also play an ancient from your hand straight to your zone. This will also activate the protocol ability of that card. Finally, you can discharge your node. The level of your node is indicated in the top left corner, and for every level of charge, your opponent will lose 1 point. The highest levels of charge will give you additional benefits. At the end of your turn, if you did not discharge your node, increase its charge by 1, and your opponent will lose 1 point for every card remaining in your hand. Then, your opponent takes 1 card from the waste and add it to their discard. The wastes are refreshed and play continues until one player has no points remaining, or there are no more cards in the waste deck. At the end of the game, add the values of the ancients in your deck to your remaining point total, and 1 point for every card played to your zone. The player with the most points is the winner. Right off the bat, the North lets you know that you're in for something different. You start off with 40 points, but they only ever get depleted. It's reminiscent of a life counter in a typical duel game, but losing all your points doesn't necessarily mean you lose the game. It clues you into two divergent strategies. You can try to drain your opponent's points as quickly as possible and hope that you have enough points remaining to win, or you might be willing to play fast and loose with your own points, hoping that the ancients you collect make up the difference. And then there's the fact that it's a deck building game, but you shuffle your discard pile into your deck every single turn. It might not be the first game to do that, but I've certainly never seen it before. So it can be said that the North is kind of weird, but is it any good? I'm inclined to say yes. I cut my teeth on head-to-head card games, and though I'm not as entrenched in that world as I used to be, I still have a soft spot for them. There's something about going mano a mano with someone, the winner being determined by who can best leverage the same tools. I enjoy how the North plays with the notion of location. The game is about moving ancients and facilities around the play area, making sure that they are in the places that you want them at the right time. Let's say you've managed to collect the trio of neural diodes in your zone. They allow you to activate all other neural diodes in your zone when you play it. So, you play this Forge Queen, which lets you take another ancient in your zone back into your hand. Now, you just play that neural diode and chain them all together. Clever stuff. There's a real tension with every decision. Charging up your node for massive attacks will leave you open for your opponents to drain your charge. High point ancients might give you great benefits by playing them to your zone, but if you can't get them back into your deck, you'll miss out on their valuable endgame points. Everywhere you turn, there's a push and there's a pull. A great trade-off to make. It's meaningful and it leaves a lasting mark. The only real negative things I can say about the North are due to its form. The rules are scattered amongst multiple cards instead of a booklet, the point tracker is also handled by cards, and flipping ancients to see what facilities are on the backside is cumbersome. But it's also endearing in a way. The North comes from a one-man operation, and you can almost feel every bump and quirk in the system as you play. But instead of making for a turbulent experience, it makes for a rather charming one.